disclaimer. Be advised that I'm not a professional trader or advisor. I am sharing my trading journey for entertainment purpose only. Any opinions, news, research, analysis, price, or other information contained in this video is my own opinion and does not constitute investment advice. I will not accept liability for any loss or damage, including, without limitation, to any loss of profit, money, asset, or any valuables which may arise directly or indirectly from use of information in this video. Trading foreign exchange indexes, stock market, futures, commodities, energy, precious metal, etc. carry a high level of risk, and please trade on your own research and assessment. Please seek advice from a professional financial advisor for your trading needs. Hello my friends, welcome to Trading KS. So today we are going to talk about trend lines. Today is our third chapter of our how to use technical chart, not to say a program, okay, just a sharing. I'm not a professional advisor or professional consultant. I do this for entertainment and for sharing purpose, yeah. Okay, so how to use technical chart. The first chapter we talk about how to use KLSE screener, a basic stock screening software, okay, that you can check basic function, basic price action, right, and a basic stock movement, right, on the chart. So okay, then we talk about the support resistance, which is chapter 2. Now it's chapter 3. We want to talk about trend line. Trend line is important, because trend line, okay, as the what the name mentioned, okay, what the name signify, right, represent, okay, is a trend, right? It represent the trend, okay. So let's look at the description of the trend line. What is a trend line, right? Trend lines are lines in the chart that traders draw to connect a series of pivot price of high and low together to determine the current trend direction. Okay, so pivot high and pivot lows. Okay, pivot high, okay, pivot low, pivot high, pivot low, right? So these are the high and these are the low of the prices. Okay, prices, the whether you use the line chart, okay, or candlestick chart, so they're different kind of chart. Most of people, the newer generation, okay, they use the candlestick chart, okay, but you connect all the candlestick chart together, you still get a line connecting them together, okay. So this one, pivot top, pivot low, right? So the upward trend, okay, show the market is on a bullish trend, and downwards trend line, right? The upward trend line and downward trend line show the market in a bearish trend. Steeper trend line means the market is moving faster, okay? So we connect the pivot top, pivot low, pivot top, pivot low, pivot top, pivot low, okay? So we connect them together, okay, to get a trend line, okay, to get a trend line. So if you're downtrend, similar, okay, we connect them together, okay, we get a trend line, okay. So this is a downtrend trend line, okay, the trend line is from the top coming to the bottom, it helps from the bottom going to up, okay, slanting up is an upward trend line, means the price is going up, this is the price is going down. So a trend line requires two or above pivot high or pivot low to be drawn. The more touches a trend line on the trend line with the pivot points, we strengthen the trend line support and resistance. Okay, so the more it touches, okay, let's say we got a trend line, right? So the more, okay, we need at least two, okay, one pivot bottom. If we are drawing an upward trend line, right, we need at least two to start, okay, to draw a trend line. You can't draw a trend line with a single point. You at least must have a lowest point of a two wave, okay, two wave, connect the bottom, okay. So okay, the more it touches, okay, so every time the price come back to this trend line and rebound, means this, okay, trend line is stronger, okay. So the more touches means this trend line is supported by a lot of people, means stronger, similar to a downtrend, okay. So they got a lot of touches, a lot of touches. Okay, means okay, this trend line is valid and it's very strong. So this is a so this trend line, let's say you got a okay, this trend line which is quite flat, okay, not very steep. This means right the price is not moving very fast going up, okay, means it's slowly going up. Okay, if you got a trend line which is very steep, okay, like that, okay, means the price is going up very fast. Okay, means the price is going up very fast. So a steeper trend line means the price is going up faster. So traders use bullish trend line for support during bullish trend and bearish trend line as resistance. Okay, so we got a bullish trend line going up, so we got a price, you know, went up, come down, so it went up. Okay, so when they want to come down, right, so we will use this area, okay, of the trend line, okay, as a support. Okay, if it rebound from here, means, okay, it's a support. If it breaks, okay, means the support broken, most likely, okay, the price could go the other way, okay, means change a trend, could be a downtrend, okay, reverse of a downtrend, uptrend to a downtrend. So traders also use broken trend line as a breakout opportunity, right, as I said, right, we got a trend line, okay, so the price respecting the trend line, okay, bouncing on the trend line, okay, so suddenly, okay, it breaks, okay, so this could mean, it break the trend line, right, it could mean a change of direction, the price going the other way. Okay, so illustration, okay, so this is a price movement, so the price is going up. Okay, so we need at least two touches, okay, two touches to be a valid trend line. Should be here. Okay, one, two, three touches, four touches. So this is a strong trend line, you see. Okay, so this is a bullish trend line because it's slanting upwards. Okay, so we connect the trend line. Okay, when we see the price action like that, okay, one, two area, lowest area can be connected, so we can draw a trend line. Okay, this trend line will tell us that it's going up. The price is going up. Even in wave, even if in wave, price doesn't go up in a straight line, remember. Okay, it always goes up in wave. So this is a downtrend illustration. Okay, so the downtrend, the price, okay. So the trend line is from the top to the bottom, and it's slanting down, okay, so this is downwards trend line. Okay, so example of a candlestick, this is all candlestick pattern, okay, candlestick. So this is the downtrend trend line, so you see the price came back, got that test the trend line one time, two time, okay. So this is a downtrend trend line, right? Okay, so you see the price came back here, tested one time, okay, tested two time, okay. So the gap is not necessarily always the same, okay, it can be nearer, it can be far further. And this is the uptrend trend line, uptrend trend line, okay, this is a downtrend trend line, uptrend trend line. The price went up, okay, tested it one time, tested two time, okay, tested three time and bounce from it. So this is support, okay, this is resistance. So trend line as support and resistance, uptrend trend line when price rebound at the trend line. Okay, downtrend trend line, okay, sell when price rejected at the trend line, okay. Okay, example of the downtrend trend line, okay, example of buy, okay. Trend line support, buy when price rebound from the trend line, as a support, okay. So you see the price come up, it came back and test the trend line, right? Okay, and it bounce up from the trend line, okay, uptrend trend line, as support, okay. So when it bounce the trend line, okay, we buy, okay, for the price to go up. So it came here and bounce again, right? So another buy opportunity, okay. So after we draw a trend line, remember, okay, always watch the trend line as support, okay. If it's uptrend, right, it means it's a support, okay. If it doesn't break down, okay, and then it's so bullish action, right, so there's opportunity for the traders to buy, okay. So this is a downtrend, okay, downtrend trend line and resistance. So when the price, okay, going down, okay, it try to go up, okay, but you see the trend line, okay, it's resisting the price from going up, right? You see one time, another time it tried to go up, but it cannot resist it, another time resisted. So this is a downtrend, means every time the price reach the touch the trend line, right? Okay, so there are high probability the price will be rejected and go down, okay? In trading, okay, a lot of people use this way to short the market, means sell, right? But stock market, some stock market, like Malaysia stock market and some other stock market, okay, there is time that you cannot short the market, they only allow you to sell and buy, you cannot short. So when we see, okay, the price coming down, okay, and it trend line keep on rejecting the price going up, right? So that is a time for buyers to sell their stock, okay? It's one of the sign, okay? If the market you can short, okay, then it's an opportunity to short the market. Sell after price break, so broken trend line as direction change, okay? So you can use the trend line, okay, to identify change of trend. Means a trend line is going up, the current trend is going upwards, right? So suddenly we see a trend break, okay, we see a trend break. Means this could signify, right? Signify that the broken trend line, okay, let's see if we've got a trend line here. Okay. After it breaks the trend line, means it can be a direction change. Okay. So let's see the example. Okay, you see the price keep on going up, okay, it act as support. Then suddenly, okay, the fourth time it didn't rebound, it broke below. Okay, after that it come back for a retest and the price go the other direction. Okay, so this is a broken uptrend trend line. Okay, so after broken, the price moving downwards. Okay, so this is a change of direction, okay, change of trend from uptrend to downtrend. Okay, we see a downtrend example, okay, this is a downtrend, okay, the price got rejected, right, from the trend line. But then, okay, first time, second time, the third time, it tried to rebound, okay, but it broke. Okay, then the price came down, retest, after retest, it goes up, okay, so this is a downtrend, okay, change of direction, become an uptrend. Okay, so let's see the example in the chart. Okay, so this is the Asia chart, okay. So trend line, you can use it to draw long-term trend and short-term trend. Okay, let's say you've got a downtrend, a long-term downtrend, right? You see the price, okay, you see the price is going lower and lower, right? So one point, second point, you can draw the line, okay? The 3 point is a better, the best, okay, draw with 3 point. Okay, because 2 point, you don't know yet. This could be a 2 point, the second point, right? So it's a second point already broken, okay, very fast. Okay, the best is 3 point. Okay, 2 point can start, 3 point is better. Okay, so you see 1 point, 2 point, 3 point, 4 point, right? Okay, so you see every time after you got this 2 point drawn, right, you see the price came back to this trend line, right? It got rejected down again, right? So this is resistant. So the price come back to the same trend line again, you see at this area it got rejected, so this is resistant, right? This is long term. Okay, so after long term, right, the price broke here. Okay, it broke this trend line. Okay, what happened? It came back and retest, right? And bounced upwards. Okay, so there's a direction change after a break of the, okay, after a break of the long-term resistance line, long-term downtrend trend line. Okay, so this is a, okay, so this is a uptrend trend line. Okay, uptrend trend line, right? One touch. Okay, this almost touch. Okay, you can adjust a little bit. Okay, sometimes it's not ideal, okay. Cut a little bit is okay, but don't cut too much. Okay, don't cut too much. Okay, cut a little bit is still okay. Because trend line, there's no one way, okay, 100% to get. Always you get 100% exact touches, okay. Sometimes you just couldn't get so accurate, okay. So we have to use our common sense, okay, a bit, okay. Okay, so this one, you see the price, right, the uptrend, Okay, so one touch, two touch. So you see it come back, okay, touch the trend line again, it got push up. Okay, another time it came and touch the trend line again, it got push up, right? So this is trend line as support. Okay, so this is a support trend line. Correct? See what happened after the trend line has been broken. Okay, so this time the trend line has broken. Okay, after 1, 2, 3, the fourth time it broken. Okay, broken. Okay, it's the first indication of a direction change. Okay, so the price it came back and retest. Okay, and then it started a downtrend. Okay, so this is how we use a trend line, how we identify the trend. Okay, whether it's an uptrend and then or the downtrend, and we can identify area for us to buy. Okay, opportunity to buy. Okay, and opportunity to change. Okay, to change the direction to sell. Okay, now you see it's a sell. So we can also draw a trend line here. Okay, you see it has a trend line here for sell, right? Okay, so now you see every time the price bounce here, okay, it's a sell. Okay, so not all stock market can sell. Okay, so some stock market can sell, but you cannot short. Okay, so these are the short opportunity for some market. Okay, so this is a broken uptrend. Okay, so now this is a long trend line, right? We can also draw short-term trend line, okay? Short-term trend line on the downtrend, okay? You see, on the uptrend, right? This is a uptrend here, okay? This is a long-term trend line, long-term trend line, okay? This one is a long-term trend line, and this one is a short-term trend line, okay? Short-term trend line, one touch, two touch, three touch, four touch. Okay, so if you are holding the stock, what we do, okay, every time we touch, we buy, right, buy. Then after that, after we hold, let's say we bought it here, 85 cents, okay, then we keep it, because every time we touch the trend line, right, it didn't break the trend line, means the uptrend is still intact. Uptrend is still intact means we still can keep the stock, right? So after here, what happened? At $1.74, it broke, right, it broke our trend line, okay? It broke our trend line means the uptrend really no longer intact. Okay, so this is possible. Okay, you buy here, sell here. Okay, a broke up a trend line. Okay, so another example. Okay, so the price came back, it touched the long term trend line, right? And it got rejected, means a good opportunity to buy. After buy, what happened? Okay, buy. Okay, so the price came, touched one time. Pivot low, okay, so the pivot low one time, two times, so you, okay, after you see two pivot low can be aligned with this start of the trend line, right? You draw a trend line here, okay, so this one will be your uptrend, okay, uptrend intact, one touch, two touch intact, three touch intact, so you see the fourth touch, what happened? Broke down, right? It broke, okay, so after it broke the trend line, what happened? Okay, sell, right? Sell. Correct. Okay, now we look at a downtrend. Okay, so these are the downtrend trend line. Okay, downtrend trend line. Okay, so when the price, let's say we have a trend line here. This one not so clear. Okay, this one better. One touch, two touch, three touch, four touch. So this is significant. This is a downtrend, trend line. Okay. So after it break the trend line, okay, means a change of direction. Okay, change of direction means the trend, okay, could be going up. Okay, could be going up. You see the price, it slowly goes up. So sometime after break a trend line, right, we don't expect every time it will go straight up. Sometime it will be sideways. Okay, sometimes it will be sideways, but it still go up slowly. Okay, so it still respect the long-term trend line. So it still got rejected on the long-term trend line. Okay, so this one, people use this opportunity to buy. Okay, buy. Okay, like here. Okay, the trend line broken, right? Let me draw it nicely. Okay. The downtrend trend line, so the price respected the trend line many times here, then it broke. Okay, so after broken trend line, downtrend trend line broken, opportunity to buy. Okay, so this is the trend line, but short term, normally we don't use this one. Okay, short term trend line to for stock market, right? We don't use, because it's in the downtrend, right? In the downtrend. Okay, this is for short-term buy, short-term rebound buy, okay, not the long-term investment buy, okay, long-term investment buy, you look at the long-term trend line, you need to break above the long-term trend line, okay, for short-term rebound, those are short-term traders, so when we see a short-term trend line broken, so there's opportunity to buy, okay, but still, okay, after we buy, we need to look at the long-term trend line, okay, whether there is resistance over here, okay. I hope you guys understand, okay, this third video, okay, hope this one shed some light in your chart, okay, in your trading and in your investing and in your chart analysis. Okay, remember, like and share my video, always like and share, support my channel so I can do more videos, okay, hopefully can benefit everyone. And if you are new here, remember subscribe to my video, okay, and hit the bell. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.